So the way I see it is people all around the world, especially in the Western democracies, are in big trouble. We are under attack. Our very democracies are under attack. Our fundamental rights are under attack. Our culture, our nations, we as human beings, we are under attack. Now, who's attacking us? You might already know. I usually refer to whoever it is that is attacking us as human beings. I call them the globalitarian misanthropists, because that's what they are. And what are they doing? Well, we've seen in the last 3 years that they restricted our fundamental rights. They just took them away from us. They invented something like what they called asymptomatic transmission or asymptomatic diseases. And all of the citizens, especially in the Western democracies, we became threats to our society. And we were treated as threats for as long as we have not been able to prove that we were no threat. And to do that, we had to go and get PCR testing. Then we were told you aren't allowed to go to work anymore unless you get this super duper highly efficient and safe mRNA shot, which we now know turned out to be a really dangerous substance. There is mortality rates, excess mortality, drop in birth rates throughout the countries, and especially in the countries that have a high uptake of these mRNA shots. So the evidence is all there, and but yet they continue to do all of this.
Anything, and they just open fire on unarmed peaceful civilians. This is what's going on right now.
The police have got an armored car, and they're just firing on your children. On your children. So I hope you're safe at home on your Facebook going, these people. Because your children want freedom. The freedom that you had, freedom you took for granted, and you've given it away because you're scared. And now these kids are already fighting for it. They're shooting your children.
Where are you?
They're shooting your children. So they're walking to the Shrine of Remembrance because they're hoping that the ghosts of your grandfathers will come out and fight for freedom since you guys don't have the balls to do it.
This is our shrine, Daniel Andrews. This is not your shrine. As a matter of fact, my grandfather's brother got blown to bits in the Middle East fighting against the tyranny of what was then, Nazi Germany to fight for our freedoms. He lost his brother. His brother went over there to look after him. And he never let me forget that. He constantly reminded me of that every Anzac Day. And I get up with him really early in the morning and go on that march with him down Powers Terrace and Edwardstown in South Australia. And there's no way, mate, there's no way that you're taking our freedoms. It's not going to happen. Welcome to our shrine.
Did you guys see Tiananmen Square? Did you watch Tiananmen Square in 1989?
No, sorry.
Well, that disgust now is what you guys are perpetrating against us, the people of Victoria. And you know it, and you can hear my words, and I can see my words ringing in your ears now. And I'm saying to you, in this, in absolute peace, and hope that this appeal to your compassion makes some sense, because you know it makes sense. Daniel Andrews is the tyrant.
Look at us, we're not enemies. We're not.
That's right.
And I'm telling you one thing.
You cannot have the word freedom and mandatory in the same sentence. Unless freedom is a lie. And here, this is sacred ground. This is proof that freedom is not a lie. But if you come in and arrest us and drag us off, then you will make it a lie.
There are just shooting at everyone now. The bullets are going flying through the place. And you can still see through here. There are kids here.
To my brothers and sisters, and if you don't know what our glorious symbol means, Google it. Now, once upon a time, a small portion of the community who had had enough of this system set out to create their own. And they didn't use violence. Their mantra was peace and love, which was strategically correct, because they didn't have the guns or the numbers to topple the system. And since many of their families and friends had ostracized them, all they really had was each other. And together, they altered the world. They were the hippies.
But this will mean setting some of our differences aside, okay, for the freedom from the clutches of the globalists. The beauty about free thinkers is that we don't agree on everything, otherwise we'd just be sheep. It's a good thing. Yeah. But we all agree that this needs to stop. Yeah. Good. Islamophobes, transphobes, bigots, Nazis, anti-Semites, anti-science, science deniers, climate deniers, domestic terrorists, misinformation spreaders, and one of the newest is terrorist sympathisers, so that one's fine.
We've got granny killers.
Granny killers, yes. Gosh, you guys are dangerous. You are, though. Because lies are afraid of the truth. That's right. You won't let them rape your mind. That's why you're dangerous. And if you've stuck to your guns by now, you've never let them. There are endless labels that they will throw at human beings who ultimately, despite our differences, have this one thing in common: our God-given freedom that is not the government's or AI's to take. Against one another, unless it is to divide humanity as a whole from those who seek to destroy it. Our common enemy, this openly self-proclaimed elite. Anyone who calls themselves an elite deserves the full wrath of those whose humanity will defeat them every single time.
Yeah. protect. Yeah, under him.
Freedom movement.